I've got just a couple of little slides to share with everyone. I think I'm just going to go over a couple of little things, and then we can do some sort of Q&A. So I just wanted to show you. Can you guys see the picture, or do you see my notes and everything?
We've got the notes and everything.
Got to love multiple displays. How about that?
There we go. That's better. Yeah.
So my first question is, do any of you guys know what this is? This crop. It's not one that we have in Ohio. Well, we do. We just don't do much. This is, we call it canola in the United States. They call it rapeseed. And it's sort of flowering about the time we're there. And I think it's just gorgeous, the fields. I'm like, I want to become a rapeseed farmer because the fields are gorgeous and the photography is awesome. So if you don't know me, you'll learn I'm a photography nerd. I'm Dr. Buck. So I'm the faculty member who started this program a long time ago. Sorry, I have a dog who's wanting to chime in. I started this program a long time ago and have run it. Dr. Specht, the other AgCom faculty member, has come a couple times with me. She is actually getting married this summer, so she's not coming this year. We're going to have one of our graduate students along with us, which will be fun. I wanted to just real quick, if you don't mind, just telling us your name and sort of, you know, where you're at in your program, if that's okay. And I'll, whoever wants to go.
I can go first. So my name's Olivia Ryan Smith. I did 2 years at the ATI campus, and now I'm a junior in Columbus. My major is Ag Comm with a minor in Production Ag.
My name is Carrington. I'm a junior on the Marion campus of OSU, and I'm double majoring in strategic communication and psychology. That's kind of how I found this like program. I know this is my first time meeting Dr. Buck, but hi.
Awesome.
My name is Nicole. I'm a third year on main campus. I'm majoring in environmental sustainability with a focus in international development.
Awesome. So I think all three of you would find some interesting pieces of this program for sure. So it's great to meet all of you, and I'm excited to have some interest beyond AgCom, because I think the more majors that go on the trip, the more you bring to the program and different perspectives, which is a lot of fun. I'm trying to see if this. We do a lot of touring on this trip. We do a lot of eating, and we just have a lot of fun. We get to meet a lot of characters, and you know, this is a sheep farm. To tell you a little bit about myself, Carrington heard. I have sheep. I grew up on sheep farm and raised, so we have to visit some sheep farms, so I hope that's okay with you, because that is my one requirement of our tour company, is there has to be at least one sheep farm, because we're in the UK. But we do get to see that, and I wanted to show you sort of a list of some of what we do on the trip when we're in country, so you can get an idea of what the trip really is. We start in London and end in Scotland. So we'll fly out, we'll fly overnight, and we'll get into London, and we actually meet the University of Arkansas. They have a program that sort of is like our sister program. So we meet their faculty member and their students, and we do the whole trip with them. So it's a lot of fun. So it's half OSU, half Arkansas. And last time we went, we made a love match, and I keep waiting for an engagement ring on this love match. So you just never know who you might meet. And every time we've done it, like the time before that, three people who from the two different universities became best friends, and they see each other every few months, I see on Facebook. So it's fun. We get to interact with another university, and you might make some good friends that way. But what we do, you know, in London, we will see the Tower of London, we'll see Kensington, we'll see, you know, the traditional pieces of London that are exciting and everybody wants to see. But we'll also go to some universities while we're there. So we'll go to Riddle College there outside of London, we'll go to some media. So, you know, Kensington, you know, being in communications, you'll get a different experience and get to see some of that communications. And Nicole, I think what you'll find when we go to some of these media, we always end up talking about environment. The environmental regulations and the livestock regulations in the UK, especially since they have exited the EU, are always top of mind of the editors that we talk with. And this picture down in the bottom right, that's the main editor for actually the Scottish Farmer, and they're looking through some of the some of their issues from like the 1800s to today, and it's consistently those things. So we spend some time at those media organizations talking to them about what do they cover, what are the issues that they're seeing, and what's fun is we visit Farmers Weekly. As you go down through this list, we get visit Farmer's Garden and Scottish Farmer, and the three of them compete against each other. And it's fun because the editors start like bashing on each other when we visit, especially when we get to Scottish Farmer, because Scottish, they just really like to like needle the English guys. So that's fun. We are going to go to the US Embassy. We do that every time to talk about what are the, you know, issues that going back and forth in agriculture, in the food realm, and in general. And this year we are actually going to go into Parliament. We've made some connections and we're supposed to go to the floor of Parliament if everything works out. COVID not stopping that, which is something that you don't get to do very often. It will be amazing. We leave London. We give you some time to tour, but we'll leave London. We'll go to Stonehenge and see these big rocks. We'll spend a couple of hours looking at some rocks and in a circle, and then we'll go. But they're pretty cool rocks. Then we'll head over to Bath, which is they have the Roman baths. And so we'll visit the Roman baths. And you guys know what the Roman baths are? Have you heard of those before? Yeah. Okay. Just checking. Some people haven't. We won't get in them, even though you can if you really want to. But we'll experience it. It's a really cute little town. It's Bath upon Avon, which a lot of the cities in England have the term upon Avon at the end. And upon Avon just means on the river. So we'll go to Bath on the river and we can see some things. We'll also go to the Royal Bath and West show. And this is a mix of farm science review and a state fair and a like community market type thing. It's nothing you've seen before. It's huge. There's livestock shows, there's, you know, community things going on. All right. There's shopping, there's food, we'll spend the whole day there. We'll talk to some young farmers and some of their PR type people, but we get treated as special guests from outside of the country and get to, everybody really enjoys this day because we just sort of spend the day exploring and they've got a natural environment section where they've got talking about trees and plants and some of the environmental regulations they have in terms of setting aside crop land for natural preserve. So they've got demonstrations and things on that. And then we head over to the Lake District, which I never really knew about before we went to this, but the Lake District is sort of the vacation spot for a lot of people in the UK. It's gorgeous. It is where Beatrix Potter lived her life. Beatrix Potter wrote Peter Rabbit. So everything you know about Peter Rabbit is sort of written about the Lake District. So it's just gorgeous. And you can actually visit her museum. And on a side note, she was actually very instrumental in keeping a breed of sheep alive in that area. So yeah, the sheep nerd in me gets excited because we get to see this unique breed that isn't really anywhere else. But we'll do some shopping in these cute little towns. There's right at the edge of town is this amazing little coffee shop that we can get some coffee and chill for a little bit and look at the lake. We'll visit a few universities and talk to them. None of them have an AgCom program or really a communication program. So when we go into the universities, we get to see experiments and research that they're doing across the board. So it's sort of interesting to talk to them about some of those. livestock to crop, arable crops and seed or grain crops. We'll get to Scotland. We'll get into Edinburgh, where we stop, and we'll see some actual Scottish experience, some Scottish dancing, and we'll eat some Scottish food and some haggis. And you can go to the whiskey experience if you'd like there in Edinburgh. We'll see the castle and a lot of fun shopping. But this is a picture of Parliament. So our goal is to get down to the floor here, which is awesome. And the Queen, her throne is on the opposite end of this picture. I doubt we'll get to see the Queen, but when we do see the castles, we know who is royal and who is in the castles. One time, Harry flew in while we were at Kensington, so we saw his helicopter come down, and people were telling us. So if you like the royal, you know, follow any of that, we do get to see a little bit of that. There's some pictures. We do go to St. Andrews. Do any of you know what's big about St. Andrews? It's such a guy thing, really. It is the home of golf. So if you like to golf, you would have heard of it. So the old course is where like golf was invented. So we'll actually go to the groundskeeper and talk to them about how they keep the greens so nice and good. It's also the town that William and Kate met in. That's the university they went to, is there in that town. So you'll see a bunch of stuff about them, which is weird, but it's a cute little town, and it's on the coast. And so that picture up in the top left is sort of us seeing sort of the ocean a little bit on that. It's just a little too cold. So that's sort of the trip. We really just go around the country exploring. And like I said, we'll see some farms here and there. We'll see some beautiful gardens and eat some amazing British food. The flip side of it is in country or in our country, before we go, we do have a class that we do the second half of spring. If you apply for the program and are in the program, Elizabeth and I will put you into that class. So it's not something you have to schedule, but at the second part of spring, I'll be contacting and saying, okay, we're gonna have class. Obviously we've been doing it somewhat over Zoom because it's hard to get together with everybody's class schedules. Prior to this, we've been doing it over Zoom. So we do a couple little activities about agriculture, or not agriculture. We listen to the BBC and do some reports on what's happening in the UK. Last time we went, it was all about leaving the EU, and it still will be about leaving the EU. Scotland also is like really itching to leave the UK. And we've been there during two votes where they've tried to leave the UK. So I wouldn't put it past them again to be voting on that as well, or for us to hear about it. So it's really interesting. So we'll talk about some of that, learn about the countries, talk about some of the issues they're facing. And everybody will do a fact sheet on one of the places we're going, so we can learn about the places we're going. So it's not a daunting spring semester activity. It's more for us to get to know each other and get excited for the trip. And we'll talk about all the packing and money and all of that stuff during class. Then in country, your grade comes from journaling every day and telling us about your experience, or telling me about your experience. I'm the only one who reads them. And then we have a blog that people follow, and you'll be assigned a day or two where you have to either write about our experience or show our experience in photos or video. Those of you know me, I teach art photography and videography. So we do have a couple days where I talk about photography on the trip, and we, you know, try and encourage everybody to practice their photography a little bit. So you can use that. And this is Shakespeare. We do stay in Stratford-upon-Avon, which is his home. And we get to go to play one of his plays in the theater that he started and built his original theater. So that's just, whether you like Shakespeare or theater, it's just amazing. Even I've had some guys who are like, I'm not going on this. I don't want to go to this. And at the end, they're just like, thank you for making me go to this, because the theater is just so different. And it's just really cool to see the original. And you can say, I've been there. So, and if you really want, you can go find his grave and his daughter's grave and all of that kind of stuff in the little courtyard there. Yeah, so that's morbid. I'm like jabbering on. What questions do you have about like what we do in the country or what we get to see or any of that? Anything sound really cool?
I just think everything sounds really cool.
That's good. That's good. You'll enjoy the whole thing.
Yeah, I agree. I think most of it sounds pretty interesting. I know the thing you said that was like similar to the like state fair sounded kind of interesting. Like, I'm curious to see what that's like, I guess, there.
Yeah, it's night and day from, if you know anything about like showing equine to pigs, it's very different. And if you don't like livestock, there's plenty of other things to do. But they, when we're there, they normally have a horse shearing contest. They'll have their shearing contest going on, and they'll have eventing. So there's a huge middle arena on the grounds, and a lot of people will just sit in the grass and just watch the eventing because it's cool. I don't know, Cole, does anything sound interesting or?
I'm kind of really interested in some of the politics you talked about with like, especially with like Brexit and like them leaving the EU, like that's something that's kind of been interesting to me. So kind of to like be there and learn it there, I think would be kind of cool.
It is. And what's interesting, and that's why I love that we go to the media, because they give us their opinion. And these guys are not afraid to give us their opinion. They've got that British and Scottish wit. And so they are very upfront about what they think about it and what farmers and people in the communities think about it. So it'll be interesting to see what they're saying at this point, because they were all very much somewhat against it because of the negative that it had for agriculture that people weren't processing through. And now that they're hitting that, it's going to be pretty interesting to see what they have to say. I have a feeling the Scottish people are like, yeah, we just want to get out of here. But yeah, the politics are really interesting. And that's one reason we do talk about the BBC and listen to some of that beforehand. So we have an idea when people start saying things, we know. That's why the professor from Arkansas has got a connection with Parliament. And I think that's going to be really cool to get us down there and see that, because I'm excited about that too. Any questions you guys have about the trip part?
I think my only question is, like, I saw that we're supposed to take a class like over that summer and everything that's like related to our trip. What is like the class portion supposed to entail? Is that just like the journal and reports, or is there not more
that's
than
all
that
it is. Okay, yeah, no, it's our in-country piece to it.
Okay.
It's like, what else do I have to do? No, it's the in-country, so it's journaling and doing sort of this little report. Unless you're taking the class for credit, in our college you can take the class and count for a contemporary issues credit. If it's that, there is a little bit more. So it depends on how you're planning on using these credits in your program. But for the most part, that's all it is just the journaling and participating and being on our tours and things like that. Yeah. I know the one thing that's a lot of interest, and I'll hand it over to Elizabeth to talk about this. I'll turn on the slide, but I'll let her explain sort of the COVID component to this.
So for those of you that I haven't met, I'm Elizabeth Schumann. I'm the Global Education Manager for the College of Food, Agriculture, and Environmental Sciences. So I work on kind of the logistics side of the program. So COVID, of course, is throwing a wrench in education abroad programming. Right now, what that looks like here at Ohio State is there is this International Travel Policy Committee that reviews every program before travel to determine, you know, is it safe to travel? Is it possible? So they're looking at a variety of factors. So the COVID rates in country, the vaccination rates. They're also looking at the medical standard and the hospital capacity. So, you know, basically, is their hospital system so overwhelmed that if you break your leg, it would be hard to get treatment for that? We want to make sure that you can get treatment for even the smallest things if something happens. And then also looking at, you know, immigration policies and in-country restrictions. So can you actually get into the country right now? What type of requirements or restrictions do they have? You know, if a country has a 14-day quarantine upon arrival, that's not going to work for a two-week program because that's your entire program. And, you know, are things open? Are the museums open? Are restaurants open? You know, can you get into public places, or is everything kind of closed down or with such limited capacity that the group couldn't really actually have the experience that we want you to be able to have? So what that actually looks like, they have dates out there. So for summer 2022 programs, they will make a decision about whether or not they think the program is viable by January 31st. So that date was picked because it's before any significant financial commitment, or before that money could be non-refundable, right? So we chose the date because if it's determined the program is not viable, there's no financial commitment at this point. We can refund, you know, at this point, the only payment you should have made would be the application fee. There's a $150 fee to apply to the program. So if the program is just is not viable, that fee will be refunded to you. So kind of the bottom line is that there's nothing to lose. If you're interested in the program, I would certainly encourage you to apply, because the only, you know, the only definite is that if you don't apply, you certainly won't go. But have a realistic expectation, right? There is still a very good possibility that programs will be canceled for summer 2022 as COVID continues to wreak havoc, you know, all sorts of things across the globe. And be considering that backup plan. So if, you know, this program is canceled and I can't travel, you know, what is your plan for the summer? You know, if you need to have one, not everybody will, but, you know, are there other classes you might want to try and take on campus? Do you want to try and get an internship, summer job, whatever the case may be? Just keep all of that in mind as you kind of move forward with planning for the semester. Yeah. Does anybody have any questions about like the application or the program costs? I guess that would be the other thing that I can certainly talk more about a little bit.
Have you released the like specific program fees yet for this trip?
Not quite. We are close. So hopefully by the end of the calendar year, those will be up. We've got a draft budget out and just waiting for review, final review, and
she's waiting on my department chair. So as soon as he tells me one thing, we'll have it out. So hopefully, yeah, really soon, and we'll send that to you guys.
Yeah, if you have the application open, so if you've at least clicked the like apply button, we'll certainly send it to everybody that has an open application, like an announcement. The program fees published, finally. So yeah, the deadline is January 5th for the application. So that's the end of the day. So basically you have all day on the 5th, and then at midnight, at the end of the day, the application closes. And I will say one thing I've noticed about the application that I think is terribly confusing, but unfortunately I have no control over. When you submit all of the pieces to the application, if you log back in, there's this green banner that comes up across the application that says, like, you've done all of the pieces, congratulations. Underneath that banner is a submit button. So like on my computer screen, if I'm logged in, I can see the green banner, but if I don't scroll down, I can't see the submit button. So you actually have to scroll past the green banner and click submit is the final piece to completing the application. So make sure you click that button.
I will say, you know, the COVID thing is scary, but there are programs that went this year, are going over spring break. So don't, you know, there's some that aren't because of the countries. So when you hear things, don't just automatically assume this one's canceled until you would hear that, because We know that that sort of rumor got around, and we're not canceled. We're going to go as hopefully, you know, we want to go and be healthy, but my goal is for us to go. So, and so is Arkansas. We're planning and we're ready, and we've got hotels and flights. So we just have to be realistic that in this world, we never know what's happening anymore. So.
Mm-hmm. Any other questions?
The one cool thing about this trip is it is right at the beginning of summer. So it's not one where you lose your whole summer for internships. And that's sort of, I think, a positive piece to it. I don't know, you still have all of that extra time to do your internship when you would get back if you need one.
Yeah, so what are the specific dates for the trip?
Yeah. The dates are May 29th through June 11th. So you'll have most of June, all of July, and then that first bit of August before you have to return to campus.
So, and it's a little awkward compared to some of the other programs, and because of our scheduling, because of Arkansas. They're weird. They have a different schedule than us. But we have so much fun with them, we keep going. So, I'll put my email too in the chat. So if you do have other questions, obviously Elizabeth can answer them, but if you have questions on like what we do in class and that kind of stuff, I'm happy to answer any of those questions as well.
I guess we will wrap up if there are no more questions, but I'll stop the recording.
I'm excited. I hope you guys apply. It really is a good program.